my dear friends, hope you all are doing good, and I hope you have liked the last case study based video, right? So today in this video I'm going to cover case study 4, 5, and 6, so that it will be even convenient for you to recollect, revise, and spend some time with ISCA and feel good that okay, ISCA has been completed. But coming to this thing, I was actually thinking, like, if any of you want to have a video regarding how to present the answers in ISCA, if it's so, do let me know in the comment section below that you want such kind of thing. Ask even your friends, please share them these videos of case study based MCQs, and if they also want to know how to present answers in ISCA, please ask them to comment as well. Then depending upon the number of replies, I will make a video for that. So basically it will also be in English, but some points of here and there in Hindi, so that max people can get more awareness for that. The reason I don't use other language as of now is that exams are written in English, and very less number of people write in Hindi. Even if the lesson is given in Hindi, at the end of the day in the examination you must write English, right? Most people will opt for English language, and technical terms like ISCA, they have to be dealt in English, right? So that's the reason why I take most of my sessions, almost all sessions, in English. Come on, let's now start with the fourth case study, and I'll be maintaining a normal speed, so you need not worry. In case if you feel it is a bit faster, you can slow the speed of the video. Okay, let's get started. Messrs. XYT Limited, a FMCG company dealing home care, human care, health care, and stomach care products. Okay, the company has been seeing drop in sales over the past few years. Company has traditional distribution channel which includes wholesale dealers, retailers, and agents. Company has been using a legacy integrated system since 2004. Okay, fine. To get better understanding for the reasons for the decline in sales, XTZ decides to appoint a consultant. So consultant means, again, you can think it can, he has to give advice on the IT needs. Okay, XTZ appoints Mrs. Venus Andromedia, Mrs. VA, a business consultant. Okay, so she has been appointed. Okay, Miss VA has more than a decade of experience and is a MBA from IIMA plus qualified CISA CISM expert. Okay, Miss VA has been given in 6 months to submit the report. Okay, Miss VA submits her report in two parts. Part one deals with the identification of the key reasons for business decline, and part two is solution to identified problems. That's also till here, they say everything is good and fine. There is some decrease in sales and they want to know why the products are going down, why the sales is dropping, what they should do, or what should the changes be done. So they appointed Mrs. VA. So she has been given 6 months time to submit the report, and she gave the report in how many parts? Two parts. One deals with the identification of the reasons, and second deals with the solutions to the identified problems. Okay, Ms. VA found that customer order execution turnaround time is twice the market norms. Means customer, suppose if the customer places an order, if you have seen Amazon or any other website or any business thing, they say 24 hours the order will be delivered, or it will be dispatched 24 hours. That's called customer order execution. So how fast the order is being executed? So that is actually, if suppose if the market takes, other competitors taking 1 day to dispatch the order, you're taking 2 days. Who has the time to wait, right? In the present system, retailers' orders are accepted by the sales representative, who sends the same to head office on email. Okay, so what's happening now? Retailers who place the order are accepted by the sales representative of the company, and that order is then sent to head office on email. So there can be a time gap from when the retailer placed the order to the sales personnel, and the sales representative gave the order to the email, in the email to head office. There can be a possible time gap. Sales head at head office gives the necessary instructions. Okay, so he gets the email, he takes the email, and he gives the necessary instructions for dispatch of the order. The process has many human interfaces. You can see retailer giving to sales representative, then he giving to the mail to head office, head office sales person taking it, then giving instruction to others. So lot of human interfaces there, and the order can undergo some changes when there is information flows from one to another, right? Any person can miss some information of the order. Okay, so this process has many human interferences, leading to a delay in supply of material once email has been sent for orders, and many times the received or goods and orders do not match. Exactly. suppose if the customer said that we need 10 boxes of moisturizing cream, 12 bottles of this cleanser, okay, something, and 13 packets of tissues. And you can just imagine with this kind of data, when the products of the healthcare and human care and everything, these things are so interconnected. Still now many people don't understand the difference in the moisturizer, okay, and a cold cream. Sometimes it can be same, it can be different, okay, and sometimes they even get confused with this face wash and face scrub. So when the products are so nearby, which has different use though, it can, the people who packing it may get easily confused, right? And you all know in the market, for example, if you go to any supermarket, if you see a shampoo and its conditioner, both will be in the same color bottles. We need to see and understand what we are actually taking. And many times even the, when you go for billing, the people will, the bill person who's billing your goods will say, ma'am, this is the conditioner, are you looking for a shampoo? Many times I got this questions from them, because they're afraid that we may take a wrong product and may again come back for returns, right? So such kind of thing happen, right? So that's what happening in their system. Then Miss VA applied the principles of risk management, come on, first lesson, and suggested following solutions. What did she suggest? Let us see. XTC needs to implement a new system. The proposed system shall integrate all departments of the company, including departments sales and distribution and material management and financial management and production, planning and costing and human resource. This shall help XTC to operate resource utilization and increase profitability. Some were talking about ERP. Integrate all the modules so that process flow will become very smooth in the organization and things doesn't get lagged, right? The proposed system shall have an online mobile app application, enabled system of order acceptance from retailers and wholesalers, mobile application to be installed on all sales representative system. So even nowadays in hotels also, if you see, we are getting the order taking person is taking the orders on his mobile, and automatically will be served the right order to the right table, and billings get easy. Else in the olden days, the server or order taking person in the hotel should remember what each table the people have consumed. So that thing has been now eliminated, so at least the billing is easy. Similarly here also, whoever takes the orders, whoever gives orders from the mobile application, it is seen to the sales representative, and without his interference that goes to the required place, the required department, and the things get automated. Then in the new system, XTC Limited plans to preload reorder level for various products. This reorder level we might have studied a lot times in our costing class, right? Various products for each wholesaler individually. So we have a lot of wholesalers and we know who orders what. So we have pre or reorder level. So automatically when his things go down, the orders will be kept automatically. Then this will help better inventory management. As soon as inventory level for product will reach reorder level, system will send a purchase order for the reorder quantity, economic order quantity to XTC Limited. This shall significantly reduce the turnaround time. Means the customer need not wait. May wholesale need not wait for the product to arrive, then give to the customer. Okay. So almost we can say it's a mix and match of chapter 5 and chapter 2. Then some sort of chapter 1 also. Then based upon the facts of the given case scenario, okay, so what is he saying? Choose the most appropriate answer to the question 4.1 to 4.5. Only 5, okay. Expert used risk management principle to suggest a solution. Risk management terminology include all. So what does it include? Risk management, we need to face the risk, so we need to manage the risk. So risk comes when there's a vulnerability. Risk comes when there's a threat. Risk comes when the asset is exposed to the threat. But the risk management will not have risk management terminology. What is he saying? In risk management principle, there is no concept of risk sharing. Risk sharing is a method of managing the risk. Okay. In the principles of risk management, will not have risk sharing. Risk sharing is a type or is a solution to avoid or to manage the risk. Okay. We have the risk sharing, that 5 concepts of risk, right? In the first chapter, if you remember. So those are the various ways of managing the risk. Okay. Those are the various ways to ensure that the risk is being addressed. But in risk management principle to suggest a solution, the terminology will not include risk sharing. Risk sharing is a method, okay? So don't get confused in these things. In general, in exam, if we see even all the 4, only this one is odd man out, right? Then, which system types can best define new system? Okay, Come on, she says a new system, right? Manual or closed system? No, we don't want a manual system. Physical or open system? No. Automated and open system, physical and probabilistic. But here she was suggesting, Miss VA was suggesting a system where things get automated and get processed. So, and it is an open system, like whoever places the order, automatically system detects it, and if they are reaching the reorder level, place the order, if they want something supplied to them. So these things, she is suggesting an automated and open system. Then, XTC Limited hired Ms. VA for system implementation. XTC Limited wants Ms. VA to continue giving her services to the company post-implementation. What job profile company cannot provide to Ms. VA? Cannot provide. Okay. She is asked to implement a system, and then after implementation, she has to continue her job in the post-implementation phase also. What is the post she cannot be given? So, she is there for implementation, and then she has to take care after post implementation also. So when implementing things, she is the one who knows everything about the system, right? She can visualize and then implement it. So user training she has to give, okay. Then system manual updating, exactly what system is doing, what is she has to guide the people and make them write a manual book. So system manual updating she has to do, like what is the system all about. Then quality assurance person, I guess no. Then new technology adoption, she's IT person, so she has to be in trend with new technology, but she can't be a quality assurance person. Quality assurance is for the products being supplied. Quality assurance is, see, just understand the basic difference. In the chapter number 3, if you remember, there is something called quality assurance concept there. That one deals with the system, like whoever is producing or developing a system, okay, they have to provide quality systems. That is different. Here quality assurance, the paragraph talks about the quality of the products supplied by XTC. So why Miss VA will give quality assurance for the products given by XTC? So that is the role which they cannot offer Miss VA. Okay. Then an old legacy system is being replaced by an integrated system. You are further informed that XTC Limited has asked the implementers to go step by step, and implementers have reasonable time to implement a new system. What are the best system implementation method that in the situation? So what they're saying, we have an old system which works, but we are now replacing with integrated system, and we have reasonable time to do step by step everything. So what is the best system implementation method in situation? System development life cycle, prototype, rapid action development, agile. By default, rapid action and agile won't work. We're not in any hurry. Prototype will work, like you develop a system and then you implement it, you test it, know the changes required, again you implement it. So it is like giving testing and finalization. But here we need a big system where everything must be done slowly, step by step, integration must be done. So system development life cycle, the entire method, like planning, pre-planning activity, collecting the requirements, understanding the user needs, understanding what they need, everything step by step must be done, and all things must be integrated to form a complete system. Therefore, system development life cycle must be completely imbibed in developing this new integrated system. Then use of mobile app by employee is convergence of two emerging technology referred as mobile computing and BYOD. The common risk associated with both technology, what is the common risk they have? Risk in terms of options, we can remove bandwidth and health hazard, those things are limitations. We have security and application risk. So common risk is security risk, because BYOD is bring your own device, it is not based on any application. They have to take the physical laptop or iPad with them. And mobile thing, the application is in the mobile. So application, if there's something problem on the cloud, it gives a problem there. But both of them together have a security risk. Okay, so the login ID, the access to the data from the own laptops of the employee, or no proper configuration of the mobile application. So these things are security risks commonly faced by both. Okay, so I guess this one is done. Yeah, we got the right answers. It's correct. Sure. Next, fifth one. Bit big, but still, I think we can do it. Come on. ABC Limited is a large data processing company. It provides services to the major bank and financial institutions for their daily credit card processing. Company has a primary data center in India and has a backup center in USA. ABC Limited was hit by a malicious program WOM called as SoBigGuess on 15th May 2019 on Wednesday. The result was that company lost all the client data from its main server. A specific bank customer of ABC Limited, confidential customer data including credit card details were found uploaded on a social media site. Oh my god. The bank brought lawsuit against the company, like he didn't get proper protection and also lost his credibility, right? What did he say now? The bank brought lawsuit against the company ABC Limited for the loss of data as well as loss of goodwill. ABC requested its clients to share available data. Okay. It took virtually a month for the company to restart the operation. Wow, a month. During this period, it lost 10 valuable clients, of course. ABC Limited, having lost all the client data, decided to recoup the same from its backup database. Okay, so when chapter number 4 is also coming into play. Then, company has been following an incremental data backup strategy. Company has laid down plan for incremental data backup for customers based upon the nature of the business. For banking customers, it allows a full backup every Saturday after 11:59 p.m. Indian Standard Time. Timing of the data backup is important as it is done after day end of each of the banks. For next 6 days, it takes incremental backup. As soon as backup database was accessed, it was found that last full backup was taken 7 days back, and since no incremental data backup has been done, company decided to overhaul its whole backup process and decided to create a daily online backup arrangement. So now they lost the data, they want to go to the backup thing, they follow incremental backup, but when they saw the backup thing, they saw it was done last 7 days back and then no update has been done. So decided to totally change the backup process and decided to have a daily online backup arrangement, not for weekly one. It took services of professional Mrs. Safe and Secure Limited, a company providing such services. The service provider will install software and all data shall be automatically real-time backed up on a cloud environment run by SASL. ABC Limited asked SASL to ensure that the daily data transfer was made in secure mode and ensures messages integrity and confidentiality. So it's like chapter number 3, chapter number 4, then services of expert, then again coming the cloud, chapter number 8, cloud management and security, again chapter number 3. So it's a combination of these 3 or 4 chapters here. Then based upon the above questions, answer the following from 5.1 to 5.6. Okay. Worm-like trojans and virus are malicious program. Each of these features are making them distinct from one another. Tick the feature not associated with worm. What happens with the worm thing? Worm is self-propagating, they don't need a host program. Exactly, they can spread like anything. Worms can make itself and send itself to another machine on its own. They can propagate, they do not have any carrier for them. They are not standalone. Okay. They are two types, existential worm and alarm clock worm. So these A, B and D are the features of worm. Then they are not standalone, means they don't stand individual, like they replicate for themselves but they don't be in a particular place, they're not standalone. So that thing is not a feature of the worm. They are continuously moving from one machine to another machine. They are not like Trojan where they just sit in a place and wait for the proper time to execute. Then customers of ABC Limited wishes to bring lawsuit against the company for the wrongful loss of the data. Anti-theft Section of Information Technology Act, whatever damages can be claimed. So they have lost the important data. Okay, they have lost the important. Which section should they approach? So let us see the sections numbers once again. So if you go, 43A, compensation for failure to protect the data, liable to pay damages by way of compensation to the person so affected. So 43A will be the answer. But still they have asked a few more things, 72A, 66 and 7A. Let us see these things also. So 7A talks about audit of documents maintained electronic form. Okay, then 66A talks about punishment for sending offensive messages through communication service. Then what we have? We have 72A, punishment for disclosure of information in breach of lawful contract. Here actually the disclosure has not been done by these people out of a contract. It happened and the worm has attacked and they lost the information. That's why 43A saying that penalty and compensation for damage to computer system, liable to pay damages by the way of compensation to the person so affected, the bank is now affected. Therefore 43A will form the right answer here. Then ABC Limited is a large data processing company. Yes, As per the definition of various information system, the nature of service being provided by the ABC Limited would make it which one? So it is a data processing company, and by the nature of service, what does it do? It processes the data and keeps and sends them for storage, right? So it is not helping in the management to make a decision. It is not providing any executive support for decision making. It is not it is not an ERP software to manage the company, but it is a processing the data and sending and storing it for backup. So it is a transaction processing systems company. Then, ABC Limited has many banks as its customers. A table is being given for the daily transaction done by few of the banking company preceding the day when the company was hit by so big F. Identify the customer whose data loss would have been minimum. Transactions are in thousands. Okay, so what is he saying? B Limited has 100 weekly of 150 250. A Limited has weekly off on Saturday 100 150 250. Okay, N Limited has no week off and K Limited has 100 weekly off and 250. So this so big, they have been given a date, right? So this so big fugitive was attacked on when? 15th May. And if you remember, the data backup was happened 7 days behind. Then after the hit, for 1 week there was no backup there. So 15th May 2019, that there was a loss. So let us see who is least affected. If we total everybody, we have 500, right? 200 plus 150 is 250, 250 500 for B Limited. 500, then we have 600, and again 450. So K Limited will be least affected. Why? If we see BAN Limited, all have around the data of 600. So N is most affected, but K has only 450, and no one has a backup after 15th, right? So in terms of data loss, the transactions are least for K Limited. That's why K Limited is the one who is least affected in the hit by so big F. Then the change of backup strategy of ABC Limited shall be best identified as which one. So they want to change. They want to change to daily processing of the transaction. And they want every day the transaction must be taken care of and must be going for backup, not weekly. So they are in incremental mode and they want to go for which one? So between A, C and D, one will be the answer. So incremental backup or differential backup? No, differential backup is nothing but an extra version of the incremental only. So that will not give them the daily online support. So A and D will not form part of the answer. Even B is also not the answer. Why? Because they are now in incremental backup. So the answer possibly will be C. So they want to move from incremental to full backup. Like incremental backup is for every once a week, but full backup is on everyday basis. They want to do transaction backup every day. Then ABC Limited is now going to share its client bank and financial institutions data with third party SASL. Yes, we just seen that. Whether ABC Limited needs to inform its customers about this and for the most appropriate statement. It should inform, right? It should inform. So let us see which answer. Between B, C and D, one will be the answer. Need to inform, okay. Need to inform and update the service level agreement and get positive concurrence from the customers. Need to inform and update the service level agreement. No, C is the answer. Why? Because you need to inform and tell them what are the different service level agreements have entered with this cloud service provider, and also have the positive opinion or confirmation from the customers to share the data. If they don't want this, customers will go from the ABC Limited, right? So they need to inform, update the service level agreement and then get a positive concurrence from the customers, right? Okay, now let's go to the last para for the day, para number 6. Okay, VK Textiles Cotton Fabrics Private Limited is an export oriented unit established in the year 2016. Okay, company manufactures cotton fabrics in India and exports it to some foreign countries also. In December 2019, company acquired a manufacturing unit situated in Dubai. Presently, company is going in the process of listing on Bombay Stock Exchange and National Stock Exchange for listing of securities. Okay, very good. 3 years has been completed. They can do. I mean, more than three. Okay. Mr. Samir Jain joined the company as Chief Executive Officer with effect from 1st Jan 2020. After taking his duty charge, he held various meetings with the company's management and the stakeholders and presented a unified proposal on future of the company in meetings which as are given below. So he gave some proposals. Let us see them. Wow. I think somewhere this such kind of question has come. Maybe last time, like if you remember, before this MCQs in 2016 or so, there used to be case study based questions. The first question used to be a case study, and four questions used to come out of it. So somewhere I think I have seen such kind of thing. I don't remember it now, but something of this sort I have seen it. Let us see. Very good and lengthy. Expansion of the company business in other foreign country includes European countries and Gulf countries and Asia Pacific countries. Okay, he wants to expand. Very energetic, enthusiastic person. With best quality products under a reasonable price, called for money for its customers worldwide. Okay, so he wants to have in place that their products must be best quality, reasonable price. Adopt total quality management. Come on, say go to your SCPM, sorry, go to your AMA, you'll find this total quality management. Spreading out e-commerce business activity and online presence worldwide. Okay, proposed sales plan turnover setting for the incoming financial year 2021 as 2500 crores from the present budgeted turnover of rupees 800 crores in the current financial 1920 with the help of boost strong sales and marketing strategy. So these lines are not that important for the answer's point of view. We need to understand to know what he's trying to communicate, because questions will be based upon the above lines, right? Then, so he wants to increase turnover from 800 crores to 2500 crores. Big jump. Recognize the international ISO certification on corporate branding. Okay. Development and implementation of IS security policy. Adoption of new and emerging IT technology like cloud computing, mobile computing, green computing for the company. So he's trying to even include chapter number 8 here, right? Adoption of the practices of corporate and business governance and corporate framework. Undertaking a business process re-engineering. Okay, project in support of new and direct marketing approach for his customers. Upgrading to all business processes through latest technology and trend, and keeping all records and documents in electronic digitalized form. Okay, chapter number 7. IT, IS audit, ISO certification and process audit. Chapter number 6. Reciprocal agreement for disaster recovery with another company called GK Global Textiles and Cotton Fabrics Limited, already listed entity in Bombay Stock Exchange, with effect from 5th to January 2020. So you can say this is chapter number 4. Okay, based upon the facts, please answer the questions from 6.1 to 6.8. 8 questions. Wow, let us try. So overall, we understood that there is a company going to be listed, and the new CEO wants all these recommendations in the company and wants it to go achieve these targets there. Covering the chapters of chapter 6, 4, 1. Okay, let us see what are the questions. VK Textiles Cotton Fabrics Private Limited. It will be lengthy to read this name again and again, but still, is under process of implementing COVID 5 framework. Which of the following benefits the company shall not achieve by COVID 5? So, COVID 5 first will get increased value created from IT, then we'll have policy development and good practice for IT management. COVID 5 is a framework that will help in implementing the IT, then management of IT also. Then, what happens? User satisfaction related to the product offered by company, that is not given by IT. Why it will deal with user product? It will deal with user satisfaction with the IT itself, but not of the user. Let us once again go back to this here. I'll just a minute. Carbit. Where are you? Yeah. Carbit. Compliance of Carbit 5. I thought, okay, let us see. This one is benefits of Carbit 5. It enables enterprise achieving the objective, maintain the IT balance between IT needs and the enterprise needs, governed in holistic manner, risk related to IT, policy development of IT, all related to IT, but not related to anything regarding user product. That is the answer for the first question. Then, VK Textiles Cotton Fabrics Private Limited has entered into a reciprocal agreement with one of the strategies of disaster recovery planning. Which of the following risk treatment approach does it indicate? So what is trying to do? It is not trying to accept the risk. It is not even trying to avoid the risk. It is not transferring risk to an insurance company. But because it has taken the reciprocal agreement as a disaster recovery plan, it is trying to mitigate the risk, right? If it takes an insurance, we can say it is transferring the risk, but it is trying to exchange it. Then, mitigate it. VK Textiles Cotton Fabrics Private Limited has entered into a reciprocal agreement as one of the strategies of disaster recovery planning. Which of the following represents the greater risk created by reciprocal agreement for the disaster recovery made between two companies? What is the greatest thing? First thing, the security infrastructure in each company may be different. It is not a greatest thing. It's a common. We know that there can be a difference in security infrastructure. We'll take care that part and then only enter into an agreement, right? We don't just enter like that into agreement. The recovery plan cannot be tested. No, it can be tested. They can take some time and test it. The resource may not be available when needed. Not so. Some resource will be available without checking. Those things will not enter into an agreement with the other person, right? The development may result in hardware and software incompatible. This can happen. The security access can be changed. The recovery plan can be tested. The resource can be made available. But the changes in because of this reciprocal agreement may create the hardware software incompatibility. Need not necessary that both companies must have the same kind of hardware and software usage, right? They can have different. So this is the greatest risk there. Then, VK Textile Cotton Fabrics Private Limited has acquired manufacturing unit situated in Dubai, UAE. A company briefed about its human resource and business practices to all the employees working in the manufacturing unit situated in Dubai. After understanding the human resource policy and business practices of the company, they happily accepted the acquisition with all happiness. Good. The process of VK Textile Cotton Fabrics Private Limited is a part of Cobitify and is a part of Dash. So, what is he saying? It's a bit tricky. That now you understood it, it acquired a company. Now, when you acquire, there will be some employee resistance, there will be some employee discomfort, there will be some migration process. So, all these things will happen. And now the VK Textiles is trying to implement Cobitify. So, what is Cobitify helping here? So, after understanding the human resource, the people happily accepted the entire the acquisition part. So, now Cobitify is being implemented in the entire company, wherever it's located, even in Dubai. So, what is this? What is the question? The process of this process of VK Textiles Cotton Fabrics Private Limited is a part of Cobitify. So, what is the process? That understanding human resource, the business practices, and explaining all the activities that needs to be done by those employees in this newly formed collaboration. So, what is the Cobitify doing? Is enabling the people to work. It is not governing them. It is not managing. It is not imposing any principle. But they are happily accepting the acquisition. Means it is enabling the people to go and work happily in the existing company, even though it's acquired by the new one. So, Cobitify in the entire IT process acting as an enabler. Okay, then. Suppose you are a IS auditor of VK Textiles Cotton Fabrics Private Limited. Come on, the question chapter number 6 has come. Company undertakes a business process re-engineering project in support of its new and direct marketing approach to its customers through establishment of new innovative information support system. So they want to have a good marketing plan, want to reach the customers, want to do great things, and want to have innovative information support system. Which of the following would be your primary key concern about the new process? So in the new process, what you'll try to see, because you're trying to have a new information system in the place to support the customers. So are key controls in place to protect assets and information? Okay, does it address the corporate customer requirement? Does the system meet the performance goal? Have owners been identified who will be responsible for the process? But the question is, what is the key primary concern about the process? You are the auditor, you are seeing that they're trying to implement a new system. And new system is for, it's a new and direct marketing. It is not indirect marketing or downline marketing. It's a direct marketing to the customers. And we want innovative information support system. So primarily what you see that when the system is being implemented, do we have proper controls to protect the assets and information? Like if the information is about reaching the clients directly, reaching the customers directly, if any one of the company, anybody of the company without proper controls has access to that customer information, don't you think there can be a possibility of leakage, possibility of sharing the information to outside party, possibility of having any cyber crime? So first we will see in the process, are the assets being safeguarded or not? Once the assets are safeguarded, then we can then see. If you have proper controls to safeguard the information and the assets, then we can see if the customers are being required, requirements are being met. Are we achieving the performance goals? Are the owners being identified? All these things can be seen only when the asset information is protected. So, primary concern will be, are the key controls to protect the asset information systems are properly there or not? Then, suppose you are appointed IS auditor. This is a common question, right? We always get it. So, this time you should not go wrong. So, he's asking the activities involved in information system audit. So how it should go? First thing we will do scoping. So very sick. So this should be the answer. Only one line. So scoping, yes. Then planning. Then we have field work. Then we have analysis, right? Then we have reporting. Then we do closure. Okay. Then VK Textiles Cotton Fabrics Private Limited is planning to keep all the records. See, once you complete chapter 1 to 8 in a good manner, any question under the sun is easy for you in ISCA. Okay. VK Textiles Cotton Fabrics Private Limited is planning to keep all records and documents in electronic form. Good. Section 7 will say the requirements, right? Which of the following section of the Information Technology 2000 provides all the documents, records, information which are to be maintained for any specified period shall be deemed to have been maintained and retained if they are same, if the same has been retained in electronic form. Section 7 says so. This once let us see all the four sections also. The reason I am saying you, I am repeating because it's easy. It's good to revise, right? Okay, this is the large revision notes. You have seen this in the previous videos also. And to buy them, it is at 50% off. The link is given in the description box below. Okay, let us come. Here it is. Chalo. So section 3, authentication of electronic records, 3A, talks about electronic signature. Section 4 talks about legal recognition of electronic records. Section 5, legal recognition of electronic signature. Section 6, use of electronic records, electronic signature in government and its agencies. 6A, delivery of service by service provider. And 7 talks about retention of electronic records. Now that is what actually we are talking about. I can repeat sections without seeing, but the point is you have to revise. So if I show the sections, it will be easier for you to see and revise. You can take a screenshot also, right? That is the intention behind. So section 7 is the answer. Then, which of the following is the practice of using computer and IT resources in a more efficient, environmentally friendly and responsible way? So environmentally efficient, responsible way. That is coming into the green computing, because grid computing is you're trying to connect various resources which are underutilized in a network. Cloud computing also like saving of the computer on a virtual storage kind of thing. Virtualization is converting the physical into virtual form. But green, all these things will not talk about the responsibility or environmental concept there. They even try, the only thing they can talk about is the effective utilization of the resources. But green computing talks about efficient usage of the resource, environmentally friendly and responsible way. So that is the answer. Is it the answer? Of course it is the answer. So this is chapter, get the word occasionally many times. So this is the case study 4, 5 and 6. So almost it has been taken 40 minutes or so. So please revise them accordingly. Keep on studying for at least 1 hour a day. Write the at least one answer. See and write one answer. Make practice continuously. Then you can hit ISCA in a bull's eye. So next video will be regarding 7, 8 and 9th case study. Then accordingly let us meet in the next video. Till then keep studying. Take care. Be happy. All the best.